We're now in a session where we have a Q&A, where if there are any questions and comments that we'd like to make to Jessica, our lovely Michaela's got the revolving mic. Please just raise your hand and she'll come around and ask you. Any questions or comments?
Hey Gig, I just wanted to ask, which of these pictures is your favourite and why?
One of my favourite photographs is this one behind me. It's of Suther. She's an amazing musician. She's a percussionist for Faithless. She's toured with the likes of Spice Girls, Kylie, Dido. And I think the reason this one's my favourite is because being a British Asian female, meeting other British Asian females that have really achieved something and have done something really inspiring and fantastic, it really inspires me as a person. And when I met her, I photographed her at the Tate Modern in London, and she was just telling me the story of how she became a musician, and basically she used to pretend play drums at home on her bed, and her nanny, her grandma, came and said to her mum, just get the girl a drum kit, will you? And that's when she was about 14, 15. So she got a drum kit, and then she ended up playing at clubs and things like that with bands, and this is in the very early 90s, she's 37. And her mum used to be the one that used to take her to all these places, all these clubs, all these gigs, and her mum used to get a lot of stick, and so did Suther. She used to get a lot of stick from all these people saying, you know, why are you, you know, letting your daughter go to these places, being a British Asian female in the early 90s especially. She's like, she's going to clubs, what's she doing there, blah, blah, blah. But her mum was so supportive of her, and she said to her, you know what, I know where my daughter's going, I know what she's doing, I'm taking her to these places. And now, look at her, she's toured around the world, she's worked with like the most amazing musicians, and I just find that so inspiring. And also she is a person, she's so grounded, and she's such a nice person. She was just brilliant, really, really inspiring. And so her photograph means a lot to me, and also I like the photograph as well. I like the way it's composed and framed, so that was another reason. The other one I like is Jabjapur, which is just on the other side of the pillar. That one, because Jab's had a really, really brilliant story behind the photograph. She had a very, very personal, because all the musicians, like I said, are photographed in personal, place of personal meaning or inspiration to them. With Jabs, I photographed her at a place where she used to go, and when she was about 14, 15, to get away from her life as a form of escapism. She used to sit there and write, and come rain or sunshine, that's what she used to do there. And she had a very tough teenage childhood, I suppose. And she, you know, to see her now, when I went and photographed her there, we went together, it's the first time she had gone back there for like 5, 6 years, and the whole place had changed for her, because she'd grown up and she'd grown as a woman, and she'd changed so much and she's achieved so much. So that's something I really related to with her, because of her story. And she put so much effort into that story and letting me be part of it. And she said herself that had it not been you, like a female, I'd met her once before I photographed her. She said, had it not been like her, had I not met you, I wouldn't have done this. She doesn't like having a photograph taken. So that it just meant so much to me that she let me do that, and that she gave up the time and she did that. So those are my two favourite. I've got loads of others, but those two would really stand out. Shot some England football players for that work, With the Olympics coming up in 2012, I really want to be able to photograph not just the England ladies football team, but China, Germany, Brazil, all of the big national football teams. Women's football is something I'm really, really passionate about. I think it's great as a sport, and I think it's something that needs to be highlighted and it should be highlighted. And with the 2012 Olympics, well, why not? And I just hope I can do it, but that's what I want to do. And then with this work, just progress it, hopefully make it into a book one day, sit in libraries, as Suki said to me, and, you know, have it that this is the first documentation which people pick up off shelves, and 100 years to come, they go, all right, this is where it all began. You know, with people like Jay Sean, Apache Indian, Bali Sagu, that's where it all began. And, you know, that's what I really, really like, but it's going to take a while to get there, but we'll see.
You were just talking about people coming and looking at your photos in libraries and things like that. Other people are saying that they think what you're doing today can be historic for British Asians. Do you believe that it will be historic for us and helping us stop being looked at as just Bhangra performers or just garage performers? And if so, what else are you going to do to help further that?
I definitely hope this breaks the barrier down, that it's not British Asian musicians don't just do Bhangra and Bollywood, that they do music like you do, like Nita does, like Vijay does, that we have so much talent, and I hope this is something that I hope I can build upon and then showcase in bigger galleries, bigger places, in bigger media outlets, get more coverage about it, like in magazines and like Observer magazines and papers that will really take a stand, and Observer Music Monthly is an example, you know, Enemy, those kind of things, and just really showcase, because I think the biggest artists, some of the biggest British artists, let alone British Asian, are MIA and Jay Sean. MIA has performed with, you know, people like Jay-Z and Lil Wayne and Kanye West, you know, who else has done that on a UK platform? The only person that, you know, could probably come close is Dizzy Rascal, but he's not even done anything like that. And that's in that specific music genre, but yeah, I just hope I can do more like this and just for people to give me the opportunity to showcase this in more galleries. I think that's the best I could probably do and push it as much as I can in the media, but I hope that answers your questions, obviously.